Hey, what's up everybody, how's it going? I'm the Friend, and welcome back to the next episode of my Diablo 2 Lore Destruction Let's Play with the Amazon. Alright, so in the last episode, we made our way out into the Bloodmoors and did some leveling up, and we also found where the Den of Evil is. And that's where we're going to be going to today, but before we do that, I just want to look at my equipment and stuff here really quick, because I did a little bit of item finding off-screen, and basically, I think I got a belt here that just has some resists and some strength and life and all that. Not really super great, but it's a little bit, it's better than what I had. So that's awesome. And yeah, pretty sure that's it. And for that at least. And in the last episode, I did mention that what I would be doing off screen was going to Charcy.
Yes.
And to Geed. And looking at the items that they're selling and trying to find a few specific pieces of armor and weapons. And what I was looking for was a longbow that had three sockets in it, a helm that had two sockets in it, and a piece of ringmail that had three sockets in it. And the only piece that I've found so far is the longbow with three sockets right here. But yeah, and one thing I guess I didn't quite mention in the last episode was that that you can use the javelins to throw them, and they do actually do a lot more damage. And that's what I'm going to be doing using for today's episode at least. I'm not going to put my bow on just yet because it's still pretty weak. I will be using the javelin for just a little bit longer now. And yeah, so hopefully I'll be doing a little bit more damage. But before I make my way into the Den of Evil here, I do want to reiterate something that I did say in the last episode with these chests that are in the houses. They sometimes give you really, really, really good items, so it's sometimes good to try and farm them a little bit. That is how I found this belt here. These chests sometimes just give you some really good items. And as you can see, I got a lot of money as well as a few magic items. And I just picked up bolts for some reason, but whatever. Gonna get rid of those. So as you can see, I got a couple pairs of boots and a helmet or a cap that could be good and could be completely worthless. But either way, they'll be worth money. So that's awesome. But anyways, we're gonna make our way down into the Den of Evil here and complete our first quest for Akara.
I hear foul creatures about.
And there are foul creatures about. Alright, so in order to complete this quest, what we have to do is kill everything within the Den of Evil here. I got a really nice buckler there. See what that is a bit later. So yeah, we gotta kill everything here in the Den of Evil. And one thing that will become very, very important in the coming areas is that there are these shamans. And shamans revive fallen allies, so you want to make sure to kill them as fast as possible. You want to kill the shamans ASAP, because if you don't, they will revive all their fallen comrades, which is not cool, because that just makes your job all that much more difficult, especially if you're trying to take down every single enemy within the area. If you, think that you took down one of these fallens, they may have been revived, and they're like running around the area trying to figure out, well, where's the enemy that I forgot? Chances are you didn't forget them, you just you killed it and it got revived and you just didn't know about it. But yeah, we are going to try and take down these guys. As you can see, I am throwing some of these javelins to do just a little bit more damage. And again, I am playing on Players 8, just so you know. Just want to make sure that is clear. Taking a little bit of damage here. Again, I am not going to be putting very many points at all into Vitality, because we are a glass cannon, everybody. It'll become a little bit easier the further we go in the game, because I'll start using bows and I'll have a mercenary, and once I have a Valkyrie, I'll have another tank at my disposal to take aggro, monster aggro. So I really won't have to worry too much, hopefully, about getting hit. And I did just level up there, so I got all my health and mana back, even though I hadn't really used any mana yet, but it's whatever. Take this guy down. And I do have a slot for another potion, so I'll pick that up. And I want to take down that guy. See, he just revived one, the Fallen. So I want to kill the Shaman ASAP. And then take down all the minions. Got another one here. And what we're looking for also in the cave here, there is a unique monster called Corpse Fire, I believe is his name. And it's your first introduction in the game here to champion monsters or unique monsters, whichever they're, I think they're unique monsters. And they're a lot stronger than most monsters are, and they have minions that are also a lot stronger. So it's a little bit more difficult to take them down, but we're really not too scared of them, I promise. Pick up this money here really quick and make our way around this way because I feel like choosing this way, I guess. And I guess that kind of leads me into that, you know, this game is really neat in the fact that it's completely random for the most part. There, every playthrough will be different in terms of dungeon layout and that kind of stuff. You will never probably find two. Oh, I'm running out of problems. Two areas that are the same in a you know, two different playthroughs. So that's really makes, you know, it's a lot more fun. Makes the replay value a lot higher. Which is pretty cool too. Try not to use too many javelins here. I want to save a few for Corpse Fire. I could go back to town really quick and just repair everything, but I don't feel like doing that. Ain't no one got time for that, right? Take down this guy. There's probably maybe a shaman somewhere. I'm going to try and take these guys down though. And as you can see, we got undead minion right there, so that means Corpse Fire is really close. He's just right over there, so we want to be wary of that. We're going to head around this way, and this is a minion here. We're going to try and single out each. Ooh, I took a lot of damage there. We're going to try and single out each one of these minions. They move really slow, and they don't. You don't take aggro by them all that easily. So we're going to try and take on each one at a time. I'm just going to go ahead and use a potion here, just in case. And that's Corpse Fire there. We're going to head around and try to avoid Corpse Fire here. And just take down the minions one at a time. And then hopefully leave Corpse Fire for last. At least that's the plan, you know. Hopefully everything goes according to plan. Oh, a chipped ruby. That will come in super handy. Because we will socket that into our bow most likely. And try and take down this zombie. As you can see, these undead minions of Corpse Fire are taking significantly more hits than other zombies, but it's okay. We're doing just fine, and we got one more minion here, and then we'll take on Corpse Fire. And it looks like we did aggro Corpse Fire here, though he ran off, which is good. I'm gonna pick up those javelins just so I know I have a lot of javelins, and dodge his attack and just keep throwing javelins, and easy peasy. It's a good thing I found those javelins there, made this fight a lot easier. And when you do defeat all of the enemies, the light will become bright in the area, just to kind of signify that you have taken down all the enemies. And then you can just head back to town with all the items that you have found and talk to Kashia here. Well. And she just says thank you. Oh, wait. No, wrong. I'm sorry. I'm thinking of the wrong quest. You talk to Akara, and she just basically says thank you. And she will also allow you to reset your stats and skills after you complete this quest. I'm not going to do that right now because I have no need to. But what we are going to do is identify all the stuff that we have acquired. So let's just identify everything and probably sell most of it because most of it's probably completely useless to us right now. All right, so we got Dex boots and we got some fire resist boots with dexterity and dexterity with stamina. So these ones are vastly superior to these other two. and to the ones that I am currently wearing, so we're just going to get rid of all those. Energy, 4 with energy, 3 with energy, that's terrible. Got a belt, that sucks. Dexterity with poison resist, I might keep that for right now. Let's see, we got a dex ring, put that on. And we have attack rating, so we'll put that on. And we're definitely keeping that. And we'll keep that for right now. I probably will switch to my bow here very, very soon. If not right away. but we're going to head over here. And call that... Well, we'll throw that over here. All right, so I did accidentally talk to her and then not listen to it. But, we get our next quest from Kesha here, or I don't know, Kesha, sounds like Kesha. Anyways, what she says is that we have to go kill Bloodraven in the burial grounds because she has turned to the dark side. So it's our job to go take her down and prevent her from raising all the dead. But we're not going to do that in today's episode. We're going to save that for a later episode. Let's level up here really quick, actually, and... You know, like, pretty much every level from here on out, we're going to be throwing stuff into Dexterity. Because we want to be able to do the damages with our bow. And our next point here, what level are we? Are we level 6? We are level 6. Look at that. So we have 2 points here that we could put skills into. And we're going to put 1 into dodge so that we have that 18% chance to dodge and attack. That would be very good for us since we are going for a glass cannon build. And then head back to this, and I'm going to throw this point into magic arrow. I probably won't put anything into multiple shot for a while now. Ooh, excuse me. Or at least until I have magic arrow up to where I want it to be, so that it doesn't cost me any mana. But I think that is that for my skills and stats. And I'm going to end the episode here, and in the next episode we will be making our way into the Cold Plains, I believe, and see what we can do there. Probably take on Bloodraven, maybe. But until then, if you like what you saw, go ahead and hit that like button. If you have any comments, questions, advice, go ahead and leave those in the comments section. If you want to stay up to date with what I'm doing here with my Diablo 2 lore instruction Let's Play with the Amazon, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But until next time, hope you guys have a wonderful day, and I'll catch you all next time.